Hello students, welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. I am very happy to meet you again. Today in this video we are going to discuss here a new topic and also interesting topic also, sense organs. Each and every second we are receiving various stimulation from environment. These stimulations goes to central nervous system by through nerves or neurons and also from sense organs. So out of sense organs, eye is the most important organ. It is an organ of vision. Actually a pair of eye, spherical in shape. Actually where the eyes are located, in the orbit of bone, skull bone. There is a socket is there in the skull bone. It is called orbit. In this orbit, the eye is located. Spherical in shape. Actually, this eye, a ball-like structure. This eye has various features. It has different structures. Out of this, this eyeball is covered by three important layers. The layers are called sclera, choroid, retina. So these three layers which covers the eyeball. So we will see the various features and structures of the eye in detail. From this diagram we will easily understand. So spherical shape. It has three layers. It is covered by three layers. Just listen here. Here the red color one. This one, the red layer from here to here. So red color one. From here, red color. This red color part and also this blue color. This color, blue color one. So this is the outermost layer from here. This is the outermost layer. This outermost layer is called sclera. But this scleroid, anteriorly what happens, it was modified into cornea. This blue color structure. So cornea and sclera, this is the outermost layer. So below that, the green color structure is there. Here also, the green color. This layer is called choroid layer. So what? Choroid layer. Whereas sclera, it is a non-vascular layer. Whereas choroid, it is a vascular layer. This non-vascular layer is called fibrous layer. So this choroid, this is a special significance is there. In this choroid, the blood supply is more. Highly blood supplies are there. Arteries are there. So this choroid is a vascular layer which gives nourishment to the all the layers. What is the function of this vascular choroid layer? It gives nourishment to all the layers and also it has more blood vessels. The first layer is called scleroid. It is a non-vascular layer. It gives protection. It gives protection to the eye. Not only protection, it has another function. It gives a shape to the eye. It gives a permanent shape to the eye. So, scleroid layer, the outermost layer, it performs two functions. One is, it gives protection. And one more function, it gives permanent shape to the eye. So, this is the outermost layer. Whereas, the anterior part of sclera is modified into cornea. This cornea. The function is, the cornea, it helps in refraction of rays. Refraction of light rays. When you see the object, actually, the light rays come from the object. This light rays first enter the cornea. This cornea helps in refraction of light rays. So once again I will repeat it. The eye is a spherical, a paraphyte located in orbits of skull. This eye covered by three layers, I told. One is called scleroid, first one is scleroid, the outermost layer. The second one is called choroid. It is a vascular layer. It gives nourishment to all the layers. It has more blood vessels also. The third one is called retina, the most important layer of these three. This is called retina, the third layer. It is actually called sensory layer. Because this retina has two types of cells. One is called rod cells, one is called cone cells. These are sensory cells which helps for vision. Actually, scleroid, choroid, retina. Scleroid, nothing but it gives protection. And in front of this, what happens? Cornea. So, cornea and sclera, the first outermost layer. The second layer is called choroid. The third layer is called retina. This retina is called sensory layer because it contains two types of cells. One is called rod cell and cone cells. In between this, here the green color structure. This is called middle layer. This is called choroid. This choroid layer posteriorly it goes to the optic nerve. Whereas this choroid layer anteriorly it forms a structure. You see this, the green color structure here. So it was lightly thickness. So here choroid is very thin, but in the front of anterior part of the eye, the choroid is thick in structure. This structure is called ciliary body. This is called what? Ciliary body. Of ciliary body, nothing but it is an extension of choroid. Cornea, nothing but anteriorly extension of sclera. This ciliary body, again, from the ciliary body, the black structure is there. You see there, the black structure. This black structure is called iris. It's called what? Iris. Here it has mentioned, iris. This iris helps to adjust the light rays. And one more function is there for iris. This iris gives color to the eye. Actually, our eye is black or maybe light brown or brown like this. So, the color of the eye because of iris. So, because this iris has a color pigment. If it is black pigment, your color is black. If it is brown pigment, your eye is brown like this. The iris, it has two functions. One is called, it gives color to the eye, and one more function, it adjusts the light rays which allow on the lens. So this is the iris. So third layer, after that, this is called retina. So iris, what? Iris, retina, suspensory. One more structure is there here from this. This structure is called lens. This is called what? Lens. Here it was lens. This lens is holder, or it is supported by two types of muscles is called suspensory ligaments. Once again, the green structure is called middle layer, that is called choroid. This choroid anteriorly forms ciliary body. From ciliary body, one more structure arises, that is called iris. And one more structure arises from here, this red color part. Here, see that this red color part. This red color part is called suspensory ligaments. This ligaments suspends in the lens so that the lens will hold in the correct position. So, iris, ciliary body, suspensory ligaments. These are the continuation of choroid. Second layer. So, second layer gives three structure. Choroid gives three structure. One is called suspensory ligaments, one is called iris, and one is called ciliary body. This ciliary body has more important function, that is called accommodation. What is accommodation? Nothing but the ability of the lens will adjust itself according to the distance of the object. So this adjustment of lens according to distance of the object, it is called accommodation. This accommodation provided by especially by suspensory ligaments, ciliary body and ciliary muscles. So these are the important features, and several features also there. So next we will see that here we can see that two compartments. See that here one, this is two. Two chambers are there inside the eye. Two chambers. The large one, that is behind the lens and in front of retina. So here retina, here lens. Between the lens and retina, there is a big chamber is there. This chamber is called vitreous humor. It's called what? Vitreous humor. Whereas in front of the lens, so cornea here, cornea and lens. So between cornea and the lens, one more chamber is there. This chamber is called aqueous humor. Both of chambers filled with a gelatinous fluid, which helps for a refraction of light rays. So two chambers are there. One is called aqueous chamber. What is called vitreous chamber? So here aqueous humor. These two chambers has a fluid. A gelatinous fluid will help in refraction of light rays. So once again, the retina, the third innermost layer, we already told sensory layers. This retina, the posterior part of the retina, here see this region. This is anterior part of retina. This is posterior part of retina. This posterior part of retina has a small bulge. So like this small curve is there here. So this is small curve is there. This curve is called macula lutea. Otherwise you can say fovea centralis. What is this? Fovea centralis. What is the special feature of this fovea centralis? This fovea centralis has only cone cells. Only cone cells. There is no rod cell at all. But here what happens? Here both the cells are there. Rod cells also present, cone cells also present. But here what happens? Only cone cells present. So this place is called macula lutea or fovea centralis, or is a yellow spot. We can say yellow spot. Yellow spot. And one more spot is there. This is called blind spot here. Here there is no cone cell, no rod cells. Both the cells are absent. So this region is called blind spot, whereas yellow spot, only the cone cells are there. This region is highly important for vision, for clear vision. Actually, for clear vision, this region is highly essential for the purpose. The outermost layer, I already told that is called sclera. Here you see that reticular part, this is sclera, and the front anterior portion is called cornea. So between the junction of sclera and cornea, listen here, this is here the junction is there. So this is sclera, this is cornea. In this region, one more canal is there. That is called what? One more canal, like this. So this canal, one canal is there. This canal is called canal of Schelling. So what? Canal of Schelling. So what is canal of Schelling? Nothing but it is a canal. It is a duct which opens in between the junction of sclera and cornea and opens in aqueous humor. Opens in aqueous humor. This canal drains the aqueous humor. The secretion of aqueous humor takes place. Always the concentration of aqueous humor is same, constant. Sometimes this canal, what happens? This canal drains the aqueous humor if it is excess. If it is excess, for example, just imagine this is canal of Schelling. This canal of Schelling opens between the sclera and cornea. It drains the aqueous humor. It drains the aqueous humor. Sometimes what happens, there is a blockage. There is a blockage sometimes. Because of this blockage, what happens? This aqueous humor will not drain by the canal. So what happens? In the cavity, this anterior cavity, this chamber is there, this aqueous humor. In this chamber, the fluid will increase because of excess fluid. Now what happens? The intraocular pressure is increased. Intraocular pressure is increased because there is a blockage in the canal. It will not drain the fluid. So what happens? The fluid will excess. This excess fluid causes intraocular pressure. This pressure causes a disease that is called glaucoma. This glaucoma causes blindness. This causes blindness. We need an immediate surgery for this to remove the black. Otherwise, what happens? Glaucoma will occur. This causes blindness of eye. So, this is the most important features of eye. One more structure is called canal of Schelley. One more structure. Listen, students, here the iris is there. So, this is the iris. So, in between the iris, there is an opening. It is called pupil. Already I told that. So, what is the features of iris? This iris will adjust the light rays. How it adjusts, I will explain now. So, in iris, there are two types of muscles are there. And there is two types of muscles. One is called dilator papillae, other is called radial muscles. It is called what? Radial muscles. And one more muscle is there, it is called sphincter muscles, sphincter papillae, other is called circular muscles. See in this diagram, the green part, this green part is called pupil. So this is pupil, this opening is pupil. So these pupil surrounded by iris. This red color part is called iris. So this is pupil. This is iris. This iris has two types of muscles. The blue color one I have drawn here. This blue color. Just listen. This blue color. It is called a radial muscles. Other is called dilator. It is called what? Dilate. So the black one. This muscle is called circular muscles. These two muscles will contract during dim light and bright light. So what happens during dim light? So during dim light what happens, the light is not sufficient. So what happens, the radial muscles, this one, blue color muscles, this blue color muscles will pull, will contract means it will go back. Now what happens, the pupil will enlarge, pupil will increase. So when the pupil increases, what happens, the more light will enter, so that clear vision will be there. So this radial muscles, During dim light, it contracts. Because of this contraction of radial muscles, just imagine these muscles will contract. What happens? The pupil will, the opening will be more. More opening means more light will enter, vision is clear. Now, this circular muscles, it is during bright light. So, during bright light, the light is more. So, what happens? This circular muscle, the black one, see this? This black muscles. The black structure is called, this is called circular muscles. These circular muscles will contract. Because of this contraction of this circular muscles, this one, the circular muscles, what happens? The pupil size will be small. So that during more light, the small amount of light entered. So during bright light, the circular muscle will contract so that it decreases the pupil so that light energy is enough. Here what happens? During dim light, the dilator muscles, that is called radial muscles, will contract so that pupil will enlarge, the pupil opening is more, so light will enter easily, so that vision is easily. So this is iris function. Already I told that iris has two functions. It has pigmented. Because of pigment, the color of the eyes, because of iris, only because of iris. And one more function, it adjusts the light rays. The third layer, that is called retina. This retina is actually sensory layer. The most out of three layers, the most important layer is retina because it is a sensory layer because it contains various sensory cells, especially rod cell and cone cells. But this black cell, see this black structure, the innermost layer here, this black structure, this layer, innermost layer, this is called retina. In the retina, it has two regions. Retina has two regions. So see this, from here, anterior part, from here to here. So like this, up to this, this is anterior part of retina, this is the anterior part. So where is this one? So from here, So this is from here to here. So this part, this is called posterior part of retina. So here also. So this region, posterior part. This region, anterior part. So this retina has two layers, two regions. One is called anterior part. It is called in this region highly pigmented epithelium is there. Highly pigmented epithelium is there. Whereas the posterior part is in this region is called it contains neural visual region. So this is highly pigmented region. This is neural visual region. So in this region, actually, it is a non-visual part because there is no very less rod cell and cone cells. Whereas in the posterior part, rod cells, cone cells are more. This posterior part has three types of cells. One is called rod cell and cone cells, called sensory cells, and one more cell is called bipolar cells, and one more cell is called ganglionic cells. So these three types of cells present in the posterior part. This is called neural visual region. The anterior part is called highly pigmented epithelial region, so that retina helps in vision. The posterior part of retina, I told there two types of cells. The posterior part of retina has two types of cells. One is called rod cells. One is called cone cells. These are called sensory cells. These are called sensory cells. This rod cells helps during dim light, whereas cone cells helps during bright light. And also, this cone cell helps in color perception. So it helps in color perception. But this also during it helps in during dim light, whereas this is 120 million cells are, whereas here 7 million cells are there. So this rod cell and cone cells, otherwise called, they are called transducers. They are called transducers. Rod cells, cone cells, collectively called what? Transducers. Why it is called transducers? These cells convert the energy. For example, A is an energy, it is converted into B energy. This conversion takes place by these cells, especially electromagnetic energy is converted into electrochemical energy. So this conversion takes place by the rod cell and cone cells. They are called transducers. So far we have described the structure of eye. So in short, we will revise all the things. So especially the iris is spherical in shape, a pair of eyes present in orbit of skulls. Actually this eye covered with three layers. One is called sclera, choroid, retina. Sclera gives protection and shape. Choroid gives nourishment. Retina actually sensory layers. So three layers are there. And two chambers are there. One is called aqueous chamber, one is called vitreous chamber. Between cornea and lens, a small chamber is called aqueous chamber. Between lens and retina, it is called vitreous chamber. These two chambers filled with fluid. Because of this fluid helps, it gives a permanent shape to the eye, and also because of a gelatinous fluid, the light rays enters from cornea and then aqueous humor and then lens and then vitreous humor and then retina. So refraction of light rays takes place because of these two chambers. And one more thing, one spot is there, called yellow spot. What is yellow spot? Nothing but the posterior part of retina has a small depression, that is called macular lutea, other is called fovea centralis. This contains only cone cells, no rod cells, so it is called yellow spot. This gives highly resolution of vision. And one more spot is called blind spot. Blind spot means nothing but there is no rod cell and there is no cone cell. So it is called a blind spot. And from this region, one nerve arises, it goes to brain, the information takes from the sense organs, this nerve is called optic nerve. So, two chambers, three layers, thing, the second layer gives what? Choroid gives three structures, one is called iris, suspensory ligaments and ciliary bone. These are the three features of middle layer is called choroid layer. So far we have discussed the various features of eye, structures of eye and functions of eye. I think it is easy to understand, students. If it is easy to you, you subscribe this channel and share this channel to your friends also. Thank you.